evening and welcome to the service of Choral Evensong in the Christchurch Transitional Cathedral. The psalm set for this evening is Psalm 27. This service is from the Book of Common Prayer, first published in the 16th century. It is part of the ceaseless worship of the Church offered to God day and night in every part of the world. This evening, the choir sings the whole service, offering praise to God on our behalf. We invite you to follow the service closely and to make their prayers your own.
Thank you. In praise of wisdom. A reading from the book of Sirach, chapter 24, beginning at the first verse. Wisdom praises herself and tells of her glory in the midst of her people. In the assembly of the Most High, she opens her mouth, and in the presence of his hosts, she tells of her glory. I came forth from the mouth of the Most High and covered the earth like a mist. I dwelt in the highest heavens, and my throne was a pillar of cloud. Alone I compassed the vault of heaven and traversed the depths of the abyss. Over waves of the sea, over all the earth, and over every people and nation, I have held sway. Among all these, I sought a resting place. In whose territory should I abide? Then the Creator of all things gave me a command, and my Creator chose the place for my tent. He said, "Make your dwelling in Jacob, and in Israel receive your inheritance." Before the ages, in the beginning, he created me, and for all the ages I shall not cease to be. In the holy tent I ministered before him, and so I was established in Zion. Thus in the beloved city he gave me a resting place, and in Jerusalem was my domain. I took root in an honoured people, in the portion of the Lord, his heritage. I grew tall like a cedar in Lebanon, and like a cypress on the heights of Hermon. I grew tall like a palm tree in En-Gedi, and like rose bushes in Jericho, like a fair olive tree in the field, and like a plane tree beside water, I grew tall. Come to me, you who desire me, and eat your fill of my fruits. For the memory of me is sweeter than honey, and the possession of me sweeter than the honeycomb. Those who eat of me will hunger for more. Those who drink of me will thirst for more. Whoever obeys me will not be put to shame, and those who work with me will not sin. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
Saint Paul speaks about the humility of Christ. A lesson from the letter of Saint Paul to the Philippians, chapter 2, beginning at the first verse. If then there is any encouragement in Christ, any consolation from love, any sharing in the Spirit, any compassion and sympathy, make my joy complete. Be of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility regard others as better than yourselves. Let each of you look not to your own interests, but to the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Therefore, my beloved, just as you have always obeyed me, not only in my presence, but much more now in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who is at work in you, enabling you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. Here ends the second lesson.
I call it with our word.
Let us pray. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth. Lord God, we come before you in humility, knowing our ongoing need of your presence, strength, love, and forgiveness. In the stillness, we bring before you those things for which we need to be thankful, as well as those things for which we need to ask your help. We pray for the world. We remember particularly the people of the United States, a nation that is divided and in turmoil. Banish from them the spirit that makes for unrest, and may all learn to live as members of one family. We also remember those in countries living with increased lockdown restrictions as a result of COVID-19. We pray that you be very present, and that all will know your peace that passes all understanding. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray for our country and our newly elected government. May they lead our people with wisdom and integrity, where decisions made are in the best interest of all people. We continue to pray for those who put their health and lives at risk, working at our borders and in managed isolation facilities. We pray that you will keep them, and in turn, all of us, safe. May they know that you are with them always, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray for the church and for all who continue to serve you here, for Bishop Peter, Dean Lawrence, and all the priests and deacons who have heeded your call to serve you in ordained ministry. We pray for Margaret Neat as she prepares for ordination to the diaconate at the end of this month. Maintain her and all clergy in truth and renew them in holiness, that they may faithfully serve you to the glory of your name and the good of your church. Through Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen. Amen. We remember all who are struggling in body or in mind, and those whose enjoyment of life has been taken away by sickness, tragedy, or injustice. May your love sustain them in their suffering, and may your people care for them in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Help us to remember and know that you are our life today and every day. You are the food we need, now and forever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you my peace. My peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,